I'm happy that I'm glad that this is over. We can now resolve and look at the allegations that that have been made against him. We have to. I have to commend our PNP. This is police work at its best. This is what the PNP can do pag led well at magandang maganda ang ating pagkakaunawa at pag-coordinate sa iba't ibang ahensya. But this is what policemen do. They go after and enforce court orders and go after those who have been had cases filed against them. At nakita natin, desidido ang ating mga pulis at ang instruction ko sa kanila. Itong last time, sinabi ko, pagpasok natin, huwag na kayong aalis dyan hanggat makuha lang ninyo siya. And that's exactly what they did. Nakita niya naman, you know, this is, we had to engage so many parts of the agencies, mga technical, yung mga intelligence services, lahat, kasama lahat yan. But it was in the end it was a police action that brought Apollo Kibuloy to the arms of the law. The question that is being asked constantly kagabi pa hanggang ngayon, nag-surrender ba o nahuli? I think that's a legal question, pero ganitong iniisip ko, hindi siya lilitaw kung hindi namin hinabol ng gusto. Ang pagkaintindi ko, ang pag-surrender, pag sinabing surrender, I don't know, maybe the legalists can explain this. Pero ngunit ang pagkaintindi ko, ang surrender, kapag wanted ka, ang surrender, pupunta ka sa police station o sa, ewan ko, sa prosecutor, I don't know kung saan. Sabi ako, ito ang official authority. Sasabihin, nagsusurrender na ako. Alam ko, may court order na, may arrest order na ako, kaya magsusurrender na ako. Hindi ganyan yung nangyari. Ang nangyari, napilitan siyang lumabas dahil malapit na ang pulis sa kanya. To his credit, ang sabi niya, yung mga follower niya, magpapakamatay para sa kanya. At ayaw niyang mangyari yun. So to his credit, he was still displaying a modicum of leadership to his follower. Kaya naman, again, I will stress, it was a very, involved police action, augmented, of course, by the AFP, augmented by the civilian arms of government. It was, once again, it was really through the efforts of what our policemen did. And once again, I stress that, kung merong mang nasaktan, ay may galos lamang, may sugat lamang, no major injuries, sige, sa tulukan, sa girian. Ngunit wala namang nasaktan na, wala namang namatay, walang nabaril, dahil walang ulitin ko. Lahat ng pumasok sa KOJC compound, lahat ng tao natin, ni isa doon ay may dalang baril. Wala sa kanilang may dalang baril. Dahil hindi mo na malaman eh, kung may dalang baril, iba yung nagiging usapan. Yung instruction ko sa kanila. Wala akong gusto masaktan. Hindi ko naman gusto masaktan yung mga member ng KOJC. Dahil tinutulungan lang nila yung kanilang sinusundan na leader. Pero bakit nila saatmat natin siya sasaktan? Patay bang gagalan ng baril? So, ganun na lang. And so, again, this is how it should be done. You can't do this without hurting anyone. You can't do this without shooting anyone. That is what police work is meant to be. And this is police work at its best. Kaya congratulations sa lahat ng ating mga kapulisan, yung na-involved, yung behind the scenes na na-involved, ang ating chief PNP ay talagang all the time, ay araw-araw nagre-report sa akin, sometimes 2-3 times a day, kung ano yung mga pangyayari doon sa Davao. So, it is really with some relief that I can say that at least this part, this phase of that operation is now over. And we now leave Mr. Kibuloy to the judiciary, to the judicial system. And siyempre, babantayan natin na tama naman ang mangyayari na lahat ng kanyang karapatan, walang nasasagasaan sa karapatan niya, wala namang ibabaliwala sa kanyang kahilingan, kung ano man yun. But again, there is no special treatment. Although he's a very prominent person, we actually, hindi na, kung kahit nas may magsabi na gawin natin special treatment, hindi namin alam gawin yun eh. We don't know how what special treatment is. So we will treat him like any other arrested person, and we'll respect his rights, and we will go through the process. The process will be transparent. Everyone who is involved will be accountable, and we will demonstrate once again to the world that our judicial system in the Philippines is active, is vibrant, and is working well.